We're continuing on our offshore adventure. We're on the Ultimate Lady and we're exploring seamounts and uninhabited coral atolls in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. We've already encountered huge dogtooth tuna, dozens of yellowfin, blue marlin and a broadbill swordfish. But there's still plenty more in store as we come across yet another seamount 200 nautical miles from New Caledonia.
It's a flat line.
There was wahoo and all sorts there then. Are they all yellowfin out there, Tom?
Another one.
Oh mate, you're getting good at those both side releases, man. Well done. Of course we don't need any more yellowfin tuna, so Ben expertly shakes them off as they get to the boat. And if the camera can pick it up just out here, probably a little bit far away, just over Robbie's shoulder there. Oh look, there's a whole bunch of yellowfin tuna leaping out of the water, and that is why I am going down to 6 kilo braid and a little wee popper. I'm going to cast it out and see if I can't catch a yellowfin on this set of gear. Oh, look at them go! Got them on, Tom! Whoa! Yellowfin on the popper. Whoa! Man! Whoa! Oh man! And while I'm fighting, oh man! And while I'm trying to subdue this fish, there is hundreds, if not thousands, of yellowfin all around us, leaping out of the water, feeding on flying fish, which makes a popper the perfect sort of lure. It skitters along the surface, just like a yellowfin. Oh, and I hope I don't run out of line. Uh-oh. Gone. Oh, hang on. I just had another bite on it. I got him on still. Got another one on, I think. They're all around us. I just lost that fish and now I've hooked up to another one. Tom, can you go back, man? I'm going to get spooled. I can see the bottom of the spool. Bottom of the... No more line left. This seems to be the standard size, and you can see, I mean, this fish is probably around 16 or 17 kilos, which is no problem for the 80 pound chair tackle, but for my little spin set, that is quite a workout. Particularly when I think what happened, I had a fish about this size on, it ran a long way out, the hooks came out, and another bigger fish grabbed it. I only had about 100 metres of line left, and 100 metres of line isn't enough when you're talking about stopping a yellowfin on 6 kilo braid. But this fella here can go right back where he came from. There's tunas going everywhere, it looks like yellowfin. Oh, beauty! Maybe a bigger tuna, you think? Well, it seems that with what we can see out here, that it's a patch of bigger yellowfin tuna. And by the line that's been pulled off the reel on the 80 wide there for Robbie, there's some good sized ones. So I might just go and chuck a popper around a wee bit. A nice one. Yeah. How far back? I wonder if I can get one on a popper. Yeehaw! Yeah, now that's a tuna. Look at the sickles on that puppy. Away he goes. Nice fish. Well done, Robbie. Oh man, we're getting closer to them. Oh yes! Got them on! Woohoo! First cast, and that tuna came head and shoulders out of the water and absolutely nailed by Popper. Woohoo! Oh man, look at these tuna right here. Busting up all around us, man, that's unreal. Just to think that we were in the middle of nowhere, just making our way home. One of our lures gets nailed. We see the tuna come up to the surface. And hello, chuck out a popper and we're on. I just lost them. Bugger. Whereabouts? Oh yeah. Oh yes! He hit it. Just back a bit further, dude.
Unfortunately, the big yellowfin tuna disappeared as quickly as they had appeared. So we set out some more trolling lures and continued on.
He's on the camera. He's right here. Put a lure out and you'll catch him. Oh, hang on.
Yep, he's sitting right under it.
Hey, I think I got a bigger one.
Wow! Big wave! Okay, that'll slow that wahoo down a little bit. That's a beastie wahoo. Beast of a wahoo.
Yellowfin tuna are fun to catch, amazing to look at, and even better to eat. But the majority of the fish just weren't big enough to present us with a challenge on heavy tackle. So we stopped on a seamount to up the ante and try for a big doctor's tuna.
It's amazing the amount of life here. I mean, we've hooked this wahoo and we've gone to jigs. James has cast out a little X-wrap slash bait and it's amazing the amount of fish life. As soon as you find some structure, it acts like an oasis in the desert. There's fish absolutely everywhere here. Oh, look, and there's a big shark. What do you got on? Holy, is that the same fish?
Yeah, big though, it's got a little bit frisky.
You better not have caught my yellowfin.
Got me a ball.
It's gonna spool it.
Is it gonna spool it?
Yeah.
Oh, gone, Ski. Holy crap, dude. I mean, we're only in 96 metres of water here, coming out of thousands of metres of water, and we suspect that there could be dogtooth, tuna, wahoo and all sorts on this hill. Woohoo! Oh, gotcha. Into the reef. That's two jigs that have been claimed by the seamount. Do you have on, Rob? Oh, the big storm limo one. Got it. Lose a lot. Oh, you want to tighten or loosen?
Tighten.
Okay, you're going the right way then. Uh-oh. Well, while it was great fun, got them off. I just had this really cool piece to camera to say about how fun it is dropping down to light tackle. Yeah.
What do you think that was, man?
I don't know, but something has hit that very, very hard. I mean, look at that hook. Look at the other hook. And look at that jig. I mean, something's obviously got both hooks in its mouth, like that, closed its mouth and bent that jig in half, and at the same time straightened one hook and snapped the other. Oh, go to sunset, dude. Oh, good luck. Okay, Kyle, now if you're going to be an angler, what you've got to do is you've got to be able to talk through what's happening for the show.
Oh, well, just holding on tight, mate. Holding on tight. I'm hoping you're not going to break and hit me in the face. So I had a lot of pressure on that.
I told you, hey, before we came, about the doggy.
You did.
Oh, and hit again. Got him. Oh, jeez.
Hey, yeah.
Holy man. That thing just about flipped me out of the boat. Yes. Whoa.
Oh, no.
Swap sides, mate. Swap sides. Come under me.
Oh, Maddie, I'm going to lose another one of your jig, mate. Oh, matey. Oh, shit.
Under me. Maybe, mate, because this ain't stopping.
Back up, Tom!
How helpless do you feel right now? Helpless do you feel?
Absolutely helpless.
That's sunset on 80. That's about 16 kilo of drag. Okay, this is really good for Williamson jigs, isn't it? Oh, stay with this one. Oh! I know. Is it another jig, mate? Just as well, the people at Williamson jigs are very kind to us. You're going to need to be very kind when we get back to them this trip. Well, we haven't had a lot of success stopping these Dogtooth Turneron jigs, so I'm trying this. Bit of wire trace, a hook, there we go, and just behind us, Kyle's hooked up again on the jig. Let's see if he has any luck stopping it this time. Meanwhile, I'm going to get my flying fish straight into the water without further ado. It'll be interesting to see how long Kyle lasts. It doesn't look like he's going to last too much longer. Hold on, mate, see if we can stay with him. Stay with him. Is it taking line still?
Oh no!
He hit the bottom, eh? Yeah, I saw him hit the bottom. And meanwhile, while we're getting absolutely wasted by Dogtooth Turner, there's yellowfin leaping out of the water all around us. Oh, hello, this just got hit. Oh, hang on. Yeah, this one's going a bit more, eh? Made it to the reef, I think. That was wire trace, wouldn't have bitten through if it was a shark. I think I just got peeled into the reef by another dog. Man, welcome to the dog pound.
Oh, he's on again.
I've done that cam up and I can barely hold on to this.
Come on, Kyle, you can stop one of them, baby. We've got to see one of these fish. We've got to see one.
I've got this one.
Okay, hold on to this one, boy. Hold on to him. Hold on. Oh, yeah. Stop it. You're holding this one. Must just be a baby, eh? How can that rod not break? How can that line not break? Something's got to go. Stay with him, man.
Should have a foot on so you can start
cramping. Oh, yeah. 6 jigs. 6! 6 jigs! More! Up, 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 up.
After getting soundly whipped by some big dog-tooth tuna that lived on this seamount, we set out some lures to try our luck trolling, and it came as no surprise when one of the lures was engulfed by yet another hungry predator.
You can see yellow fins everywhere on the tow camera. Yeah, little ones.
Looks like another yellow fin.
Well, is that a wahoo? Oh, it's a nice one too. Got the welcome aboard bat. Welcome aboard, Mr. Wahoo. Hope you enjoy your stay aboard the Ultimate Lady. You'll be residing in our freezer and perhaps into the galley onto the dinner plate later this evening. It's always neat when you're in this part of the world to throw out a Rapala. Now this is an X-wrap Rapala, dives down to 30 feet, so it opens up all sorts of things like dog-tooth tuna, giant trevally, even yellowfin tuna. Just about anything will eat one of these. And just as we're coming back in towards the reef, I'd like to flick one of these out, and who knows what might eat it. Well, there you go, I was saying something a moment ago about putting out one of these lures and hopefully it'll get eaten. Well, it's been eaten. The next thing to do is see whether or not we can find out what it is by getting it in. We've got it pretty close now. Big barracuda. That is a mother of a barracuda. Far out, this is bigger barracuda than I've seen anywhere. Obviously a lot different than the barracuda with a T that we get at home. These are barracuda with a D. That is one heck of a set of dentistry right there. You know, you can see how they just absolutely destroy your tackle. And as I was saying, everything in the tropics fights hard and has got big teeth. Please, mate. James just asked me, do I want a rod bucket? Hell yes. I mean, this really is fun, and I mean, half the fun is just not knowing what the heck it is you've got on. I mean, this fish, after running down towards the ground, has come back up to the surface, so I'm always wondering whether it's another barracuda. Doggy. Wicked. Sweet ass. Look at that, he's absolutely munched on that Rapala. You got him, mate? Be careful of those teeth, dude. Yeah! Doggy! What do you want to do, Tom? You want to keep him for a feed, or you want to eat him? Nah? Oh well, it's this fish's lucky day. We've already got enough wahoo for a meal. Another tuna. I'm just going to... Well, I mean, I'm going to stay right away from the teeth is what I'm going to do. James is on the pliers there. He's just going to whip the hooks out. I'm quickly going to get a sneaky photo in before throwing that fella back. You've got to be stoked with that. Chuck out a Rapala at the end of the day and wind up with a nice doggy. You beauty.
While we've been getting amongst the tuna on this trip aboard the Ultimate Lady, let's take a sneak look back at a previous trip where we encountered giant black marlin.